Welcome back to Northern Italy and to the World University Speed Skating Championships here on Eurosport. So, Lollobrigida leads for Italy, but we'll start to move through the seeds and the faster times. On the inside lane then, to start this one, Yelizaveta Kreptogova of Russia. In the blue and white suit, and then the distinctive orange speed skating suit of Jessica Merkins of the Netherlands. Kreptogova, this is the shortest distance that she's likely to be doing in an individual sense at this championships. Law student from Murmansk State Technical University. Up against, just 19 years of age, so giving away a few years of experience to Jessica Merkins, the 24-year-old from Utrecht University. Clever girl, neuroscience student, pursuing a speed skating career alongside her studies, and that's what Fisu do so superbly well, giving the opportunities that they do to students around the world to get that sport, study, life balance right. Not easy. What a wonderful way to move through your university career with access to events like this, and Merkins and Kreptogova looking to make the most of it. Merkins also 3,000 metres, the shortest distance she'll skate. She's also skating the 5,000 and the mass start. And looking to improve on the 10th position that she got in the Almaty 2014 3,000 metre event at the same championships. Third time that the World University Speed Skating Championships has been staged. More and more athletes, more and more countries as well. Every time it's staged, becoming very popular now and pretty much an established part of the student sport calendar. Halfway mark then. No surprise to see Merkins comfortably up on the time of Lollobrigida and Kreptogova as well. At the moment in second position, she too has a handy advantage over the Italian. Always a good sign when the athlete is able to keep that inside arm firmly in place just around the back to help with that aerodynamic position, and then the single arm drive with the outside arm. We'll see that change as the athletes come to the line and begin to drive with both arms in a similar way to the way that they work from the line, the start line. Well, good rhythm here from Merkins in the orange. Netherlands will be able to claim the lead here as long as she stays upright. Kreptogova just struggling to stay with her, and she's just losing that disciplined shape. Well, handy lead for both athletes at the moment. Over Lollobrigida, 4:49.53. Okay, switches to the outside. Looks very, very comfortable on the long bends as the taller of the two skaters. Dutch coaches and teammates shouting her on to the last 400 metres. The belt goes. And Merkins with the best part of 11 seconds to play with, but Kreptogova is coming back into it here. They'll have a last switch. Kreptogova now goes to the outside lane, and Merkins goes to the two-arm drive down the straight towards the final bend. The Dutch woman will switch to the inside, but this is going to be mighty close coming off this bend. Kreptogova just running out of a little bit of steam there. And the better drive comes from the Dutch woman as she moves to the line. This is going to be the lead, and it's going to be the lead by a comfortable distance. 4.36 then for Jessica Merkins, 05, 4.36, 6.4. Not much in it. Merkins then takes over in gold medal position for the Netherlands. With four sets of pairs still to come. But there's plenty of room in terms of the timings. Good skate though, very good skate from both athletes, and they will surely be keeping one eye on that podium. The lead is with the Netherlands and Jessica Merkins at 4.36.05 as Angelika Fudoesz in the red and white suit of Poland starts inside.
Ready.
Alongside Eliska Drumalova of the Czech Republic. She goes in the outside lane, red and blue speed suit. Quite a lively start from both athletes, driving hard into that pace. They're trying to get the speed up, and then it's about the maintenance with that wonderful metronomic rhythm. So familiar to the speed skaters, and I'm not surprised to see after that industrious start that we have the lead. Both athletes here capable of very quick times, but in particular the Polish athlete Angelika Fudoesz with a PB of 4.18.27. Now she set that back in 2013. So it's a while since she skated that fast in 3,000 metres, but certainly has the class, does the 23-year-old physical education student. Drumalova of the Czech Republic, all-rounder. So she's doing 500, 1,000, 1,500 and 3,000, then the mass start and the team pursuit as well. Another physical education student. Not always the case that all the students we see are sports students. We've seen all sorts of different degrees and backgrounds for our speed skaters so far. And Fudoesz here putting together a very, very strong effort, and Drumalova has been left at the moment. Poland looking good. One medal already through Adrian Wiuga. Bronze medal in the 1500 metres earlier this evening. So Poland will have a podium to celebrate. Whatever. Heidegger of Austria incidentally taking the silver, and Hungary's Konrad Nosch taking the gold medal in the men's 1500. Halfway mark then, so four laps to go for Fudoesz. Best part of 3 seconds the advantage, which is healthy. But remember, an athlete of this quality should be able to time things in order to have a little bit left in the tank. Rare skill to be able to work the way these athletes do. It's not just about the physicality of this sport. It's about making sure that you're able to exert your efforts, you're able to apply that power through the race. And a little bit of a drift there from Angelika. Just got caught up with the skates coming off that bend into the straight, but looks strong again now. Has recovered her composure as Drumalova switches to the inside lane. Time then to start thinking about the clock. 4.36.05 is the lead time at the moment for Jessica Merkins. And Yelizaveta Reptogova of Russia as well was quick at 4.36.64. But Fudoesz with plenty in hand as she moves through to the final stages of this race. And still looks full of energy there. That's a good effort. Really good drive down the straight. And Angelika looking powerful here. So the bell and 400 to go. Fudoesz maintaining that rhythm, maintaining that discipline. Remember, she has a PB some 10 seconds faster than the lead time. But on this ice, in these conditions, it's not going to be easy. And she's put together a very, very good skate here. Now needs to maintain that discipline coming off the last bend. Goes to the two arms to drive for home down the straight. And 4:36.05 should be comfortably surpassed here. We're going to have a new lead time, and that lead time is 4:31.52. Angelika Firoej then for Poland moves into gold medal position. 4:39.06, that's an excellent skate as well, but not quite in touch with Reptikova and Merkins. Lively start from both athletes, but it was Firoej who was able to really exert the pressure on a much more consistent basis and moves into a very good lead. So Poland, as they did in the men's 1500, with the gold medal position at the moment. Wilhelmine Knoschen of the Netherlands on the inside lane goes alongside Anna Pristalova of Russia on the outside lane, with our lead time at 4:31.52.
Ready
to beat. Knoschen on the inside, just 20 years of age, from the University of Applied Sciences. She studies a whole set of social sciences at the start of her degree. Philosophy, arts, law, fine arts, all part of what she's working towards. Then she'll specialise after that. And the same can be said of her skating. She's a bit of an all-rounder, so we'll see her in the 500, 1500, 3000 and 5000, as well as the team pursuit. Knoschen. Just asking for a little more, the Dutch coach at the moment. Wants that rhythm up a touch. And for Anna Pristalova, the 22-year-old physical education student from the Russian Vocational State University. We'll see her in 15 and 3,000. And also in the various relays. Indoor athlete at the moment in touch with the pace that we saw from the Polish skater, Furoes. Two more Polish skaters to come. Remember, they were the most successful nation in Almaty in 2014. And look, odds on to add medals here. Magdalena Kishon goes against Takahashi of Japan in the next heat, and then the final heats. Anna-Marie Boer of the Netherlands goes against the last of the Polish skaters, Ursula Wadarczyk. Time just drifting a little bit for Knoschen, but a real improvement there from Pristalova. Just a second and a half in it. Pristalova moves to an inside lane with a little bit of a sway. That's better. Good tight line from the Russian. But a little sway of the head from Pristalova. An indication that she's losing a little bit of form here. You would really like to see that upper body movement restricted to a minimum. And the top skaters will be absolutely rock solid where that is concerned. Think about it, you have athletes that have trained to such a level that they have huge muscle groups to supply with oxygen. Rather like the swimmers over distance, you'll see them using various techniques to try and preserve as much of that form as they can, and by going to both arms behind the back, then you're at least saving the work of the muscle groups around the shoulders and back. But you can't stay in that position all the time. You still need that single arm for the rhythm. Athletes trying to focus very firmly ahead of them. Forget the pain that he's building. Is pretty much even Steven between these two. And with two laps to go, Nossen just ahead of Pristalova. And that early promise from the Russian, not quite delivering on it at the moment, but real medal opportunities here for both athletes. There's a possible bronze if they can keep this form going in terms of their position with two groups to go. Oh, and Pristalova looking tired. That is a very tired outside line from the Russian. Bell to come. That was quite a laboured 400 metres from Pristalova. But Knossen looks like she's got something left here. And that is a massive effort from the Dutchwoman. Well, clearly feeling good because that last 400 metres was blistering and she's gone to two arms down the straight ahead of this final curve. She'll kick across now to the inside. Pristalova looks out of it. But Knossen moving round on a fantastic line. Now then, can she push for the lead? 4:31.52. It's going to be very, very tight indeed. And the Netherlands are in the lead. What a skate from Knossen. That last 800 metres was phenomenal. 4:30.83. And Wilhelmine Knossen moves into gold medal position, knocking Angelika Furoege down into silver on 4:31.52. Well, who'd have believed it? She was away off the pace in the early phases, but that last 800 metres, very quick indeed. Knossen in gold medal position. The Netherlands have the lead with Wilhelmine Knossen at 4:38.3 in this women's 3,000 metres at the World University Speed Skating Championships here in Baselga di Pine in Trentino in northern Italy. The Dutch have one more athlete to go in the final heat, Annemarie Boer. But this is the penultimate heat. Nana Takahashi in the darker of the ski suits on the inside line for Japan. She starts inside lane. Magdalena Kishon of Poland starts on the outside lane. Poland's success rate in Almaty was huge, and they have a medal already this evening from the men's 1500, but it's not going to be a gold unless Kishon or Wodarczuk can turn it on. Poland with two more chances, and we have to say happy birthday to Magdalena, turning 21 today. Let's see if she can do it in style. At the moment, Takahashi. Thank you, Sean, posting very good splits. That's a great start from both athletes. Nana Takahashi from the Gakuin University, where she's studying business administration and social sciences. The 22-year-old Magdalena is a physical education student. She'll be skating in the 3 and the 5,000 metres, but Takahashi is a real all-rounder. Not skating any of the team events at the moment, but will skate individually 500, 1,000, 1,500, 3,000 and 5,000. So just about the full house for Takahashi. And boy, does she look good. Very, very strong for Takahashi. And this won't be feeling too pleasant at the moment for Kishon. Just looking down at their personal bests, they are both comfortably underneath the lead time with their indoor track times. So it's going to be slower tonight, but they are both capable of a medal. Kishon at 4:17.44, but Takahashi is the form athlete. And in terms of the field, Takahashi is the favourite for gold with that PB of 4:12.50. Again, both times. time set a couple of seasons back, so interesting to see what sort of form they're in here. Takahashi, I have to say, looks absolutely superb. But remember, three laps to go. Lots can happen in 400 metres. Lots can happen, as was proved by Knossen in 800 metres. Blistering pace over the last two laps from the Dutchwoman for that lead time. I have to say, the birthday girl is looking tired. Just had a quick look at my dates again. It's actually tomorrow Magdalena turns 21, so sorry about that. We were a few hours early with the happy birthday, but she won't be feeling much like a birthday celebration at the moment. This is hurting the Polish athlete, but for Takahashi, well, continuing to move towards a 6 second advantage. Shishan's not far off the pace, but I'm not sure that she's got enough left to really pressure the podium. That looks like very, very hard work for Magdalena. For Takahashi, that is wonderful form. Look at this from the Japanese skater as she hits the bell. 400 metres to go. The gold medal is hers to lose. Brilliant skate. She's moved it over the 6 second mark. She's got a lot in the bag here. Plenty in hand. Two very good skaters to follow, but this is about Takahashi trying to lay down a mark that the penultimate pair just cannot match, or the final pair even cannot match. It's the penultimate group with Nana Takahashi, and Nana is going to set a very good time. 4:38.3 isn't even in the picture. This is going to be a massive lead for Takahashi, and it is 4:24.16. And a very tired Kishan crosses the line at 4:32.32, which in the context of this particular 3,000 metre race is not shabby. But our new gold medal time is a very, very good one. 4:24.16. I'm sure Annemarie Boer of the Netherlands and Ursula Vladarchuk will be perfectly aware of that time. Been keeping one ear on the race. And there is Annemarie Boer, personal best at 4:23.62, it says, for 3,000 metres. I've got her a little bit quicker at 4:17.37. Vladarchuk's time, though, is correct at 4:13.87. So two quality athletes to finish off the women's 3,000 metres. It's 4:24.16 to beat. And away we go. Boer on the inside in the orange ski suit of the Netherlands. Vladarchuk, slightly faster personal best for Poland in the red speed suit on the outside. But I think this is going to be mighty tight. And I think Takahashi might just have put down a marker that will prove that little bit too tough to beat. A cautious start from both athletes. Now I'm going to look for rhythm through the centre part of this race. 22-year-old Dutch woman, Annemarie Boer, goes to the University of Groningen, where she's a human movement scientist. And the Dutch, when you think about the development of the clap skate, the Dutch have had so much to do with technology in this sport and the development of this sport through students like Annemarie Boer over the years. And from Vladarchuk's point of view, the 21-year-old physical education student, we're going to see her in the 1500 and 3000 metres. So she's keeping her powder dry, as it were. Going to race twice and look to medal twice. Now her PB was set not that long ago in November in Calgary. And that 4:13.87 was very impressive indeed. So you have to assume that Vladarchuk, rather like Knossen, is going to plan her race for real work during the last 800 metres. Very, very close between these two at the moment. Looking comfortable inside line at the moment, so that lane separation. She'll put on quite a bit of distance here. But drifting out to 5 seconds off the pace for Darchuk, that's an awful lot of work to do over the closing laps. Well, Knossen closed around about 4 seconds over the last 800 metres. Darchuk looks strong. Definitely looks strong. Well, the split still remains over 5 seconds, the difference. Pacing exactly the same on those 35.6 second laps. Darchuk still looks good. Just getting a little ragged round that outside, but trying to find that rhythm once again. Just lost a bit of drive coming off that bend, but no such problem for Vodarchuk. 800 metres to go then, and it's drifted over 6 seconds for the Polish skater. But this is where Knossen went. This is where she started to ramp it up. Let's see if Ursula can do the same and put some pressure on Nana Takahashi's lead time at 4:24.16. Remember, Japan in gold medal position. And at the start of this evening, if you'd said Hungary, Japan for the two gold medals, I don't think a lot of people would have picked that combination. 400 metres to go then. The work really now has to start for Vladarchuk if she wants a place on the podium. I think that's all that's left to her with the best part of 7 seconds to find. Boer's difference drifts out to 10 seconds. Well, she's trying really hard here, is Vladarchuk. But 4:24.16 is going to be beyond her. Is this going to be good enough for a medal for Poland? Real pressure here on Vladarchuk, and second place for silver at 4:29.66. So she did find time on those closing two laps, but left it mighty late. Boer, though, just out of the running. Well, it's been a good race, and it's our two fastest personal bests coming into this one that have taken gold and silver. And let's confirm that for you. The women's 3,000 metres goes to Nana Takahashi of Japan, 4:24.16. Ursula Vladarchuk takes that silver medal, and Wilhelmine Knossen, with a fabulous last 800, manages to just get on to the podium ahead of Furoesh in fourth position. So the Netherlands have a medal, Poland have a silver, second medal of the evening, but Japan, along with Hungary, have a gold. Amazing stuff. Well skated by Takahashi. We'll take a short break there. The men's pursuit to come.
Follow the World University Championships. FISU, today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.